Today I'm at the Auburn, California airport, and I want to talk about localized winds. Now, airports are typically aligned with the direction of localized winds, and these are, as you can see on the diagram on the second one here, we're going to call them valley and mountain breezes. So here in Auburn, we have to my left, up slope here is the east, and those are the Sierra Nevada mountains, and to my right, this direction, where this airplane is taking off, is to the west. Now what typically happens here is in the morning the winds come from the east, from the mountains, and then by the afternoon, let's say 11 o'clock in the morning actually, before we get to the afternoon, the winds switch direction and they come from the valley. Straight out from Auburn is Lincoln, California, and that is where it will start to heat up in the afternoon, and then those winds will move on upslope. So at the moment now I can feel the winds. They're kind of variable because we have a storm coming in, but I wanted to go over the details of this right now. So basically, it's a reversal of inland winds due to differential heating. So think about it, at night in the Sierra Nevadas, it's definitely going to get colder, and that dense air will drain down the slopes. We have a valley I'll show you in just a second here. And so folks would line up to go upwind, in other words, into the wind, toward where the wind is drifting down toward their wings. And then in the afternoon, the winds will come from the west or from Lincoln, like I said. And folks will switch runways. In this case here, it's going directly out toward the west. The winds are coming from the west, so we'd fly into the winds to take off. Okay, so behind me here is to the east, and that is where airplanes typically have the winds coming down slope in the morning, so they'd fly into this direction where the winds are coming down. Again, this is to the east, this Sierra Nevadas. Okay, so this fellow is taken off, or woman, is taken off to the west right now as the winds are kind of switching and coming from the west. Okay, next we're going to talk about sea land breezes. It's the same idea with dense air flowing downslope. Okay, so if we were going to fly west and head to the ocean, let's say Santa Cruz, we would start to have these kinds of breezes. Okay, we're going to call them sea land breezes. Basically, it's the same idea, is that during the daytime, let's say the beach heats up, maybe around noon again, and all of a sudden the air rises on the land and draws in the sea breeze. However, at night, basically what's going to happen is the land will cool down fairly quickly, let's say around midnight, and then the air would sink back down. And it's just going to go from the land to the sea at night. And then by, let's say, noon the next day, the same process happens over and over again, and that is the air is drawn in and we have our sea breezes. And these are all thermally induced, by the way. And there's one other one too I wanted to talk about that's really straightforward, and that's the katabatic. Okay, katabatic winds are thermally induced as well. This is cold air in the Arctic and the Antarctic. Let's say it's 10,000 feet up in those mountains in the Antarctic. It's very, very cold, very dense. Comes screaming down off these mountains, 100 miles per hour. Makes the emperor penguins even colder than they already are. And that can happen also, let's say, in the Alps where we have these high mountains with cold mountain air. Okay, one last one real quickly are the fern winds. And it has kind of a funny pronunciation. It's a German word. The spelling is a little unusual. We call them the Chinook winds or the Santa Ana winds in Southern California. These are dynamically induced, in other words, movement in, let's say, in the Santa Ana winds case, out in the Great Basin over St. George, Utah, you'll have high pressure sinking air. This is on a, you know, United States scale, large scale, zoomed out that is. And that air starts to push towards the mountains, let's say the transverse range, San Gabriel, San Bernardino Mountains. It goes over those mountains as it goes down from, let's say, several thousand feet to sea level, that air is compressed, it is heated, and that's why we get such warm winds, let's say in February or March, here we are in March, that tends to also create very strong winds, and it's very dangerous for fires. So anyway, we're gonna wrap it up with that before it gets too noisy here at the Auburn Airport, and I hope you understand localized winds.